So today's class I'll be explaining different ways of writing or ways of designing the ripple counters using positive edge trigger JK or T flip flop and negative edge trigger JK and T flip flops. So in the regular class, in the regular the video whatever I had uploaded, in that we have discussed in ripple counter, that is asynchronous counter, using positive edge trigger T flip flop. Okay. So first I'll write the circuit, then I'll explain how a binary ripple up counter and down counter can be designed using positive and negative edge trigger JK or T flip flop. Okay. So any one of these question you can expect in your exam. So since we have discussed only one circuit in the class, let me give you all the four circuits. Also up down counter in the same circuit using positive or negative edge trigger JK or T flip flop. So in the regular class, I have given you a circuit of binary ripple up counter using positive edge trigger T flip flop. So this is a circuit, a part of the circuit I have written. Let me complete the circuit. So we have designed binary ripple up counter, that is asynchronous counter, using positive edge trigger T flip flop. So if you just write a triangular symbol at the clock pulse, that means that is a positive edge trigger T flip flop. If you are writing a bubble here, that indicates that it is a negative edge trigger T flip flop, right? So, since it is an asynchronous counter, since it is a ripple counter, we are going to connect clock pulse directly only to the first T flip flop. Okay? For the remaining T flip flop, what is the clock pulse? Clock pulse is from the previous flip flop output. Either it can be from the Q or maybe from Q bar. It depends on what circuit you are designing. Okay, now. Now what is the circuit we are designing? We are designing ripple up counter using positive edge trigger T flip flop. So for this you have to connect what? We have discussed this circuit already. So to work this circuit as up counter, we have used a positive edge trigger T flip flop. So we have connected Q bar as clock. Q bar of previous flip flop is connected as clock pulse to the next flip-flop. Okay, so this is the circuit of binary ripple up counter using positive edge trigger T flip-flop. So what is the counting sequence you are going to get for every positive edge of the clock? For every positive edge of the clock, up counter. So it starts from 0000, 0001, next positive edge of the clock, 0010, same way you are going to get till where? Till 1111. It's a binary ripple up counter. So we have used 4 flip flops. So you're going to get 4 bits as output, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. How exactly we are going to get this output, that also I have explained in the regular class. Okay. So one very important thing is Q0 is the output of first flip flop, right? You have denoted the output of first flip flop as what? Q0. This Q0 should be the LSB here. This Q0 should be the LSB bit in your counting sequence. Okay. When you analyze the working and when you write the waveforms, then you will come to know why Q0 will be the LSB bit here. Okay. So now, this is the circuit of binary ripple up counter using positive edge trigger T flip flop. In case in your exam, if they ask you to write the circuit of binary ripple up counter using positive edge trigger JK flip flop, what has to be done? JK means, this is the logic symbol of a JK flip flop. JK, clock, Q, Q bar. Okay. So how do you convert a JK flip flop into T flip flop? Conversion also we have learnt. So to convert a JK flip flop to T flip flop, you just have to short JK and call this as T flip flop. This is how you can convert a JK flip flop into T flip flop. Okay. So what is the truth table of a function table of a T flip flop? T input, output is this. If T is 0, what is the output? If T is 0, output is same as the previous state. If T is 1, output is the complement of previous state. Correct? Yes. So JK Q plus, this is the output. So JK, if you give T as 0, what happens here? 0 0, J is 0, K is 0. J is 0, K is 0. What is the output of a JK flip flop? Previous state. So you are going to get Q plus as what? Q. If you give T as 1,
J is 1, K is 1. J is 1, K is 1. When JK 1, 1, what is the output? Next take is the complement of previous take. You're going to get Q bar. So you're going to get the truth table of a T flip flop. Right? So this is how you can convert a JK flip flop into T flip flop. You have to short JK input that will work as a T flip flop. Now in your exam, instead of designing the binary counters using T flip flop, if they ask you to design it using JK flip flop, what you have to do? Use JK. Okay? Use JK flip flop here. JK. Just short JK, both. JK, short JK input. JK, short both. JK. So when you short both JK inputs, this flip flop will now work as what? T flip flop. And you are going to connect, this will be T. JK you have shorted, this will be T. And T you are connecting it to logic 1. Same circuit, JK flip flop, you just have to short JK. Now this is binary ripple up counter using positive edge trigger JK flip flop. Using positive edge trigger JK flip flop. Now, how do we design a binary ripple down counter? Binary ripple down counter using positive edge trigger JK flip flop. Down. Okay, this will now work as what? Up counter. How do we design binary ripple down counter using positive edge trigger JK flip flop? Very simple modification. If you want to work this circuit as down counter, instead of connecting Q bar as clock, you have to connect Q to clock. Q to clock. Okay, that is the only modification you have to do. Connect Q to clock pulse. Here, connect Q to clock pulse. Okay, now this will work as what? Binary ripple down counter. Down counter means how will be the counting sequence? So down counter, down count. So 1, 1, 1, 1, down. 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. So then till 0, 0, 0, 0. This is how we can design a binary ripple down counter using positive edge trigger JK flip flop. Okay? So both positive edge trigger JK or T flip flop. Up counter, what we have to do? Connect Q bar as clock. Down counter, connect Q as clock. Okay? So now, the next one is, how do we design a binary ripple up counter using negative edge trigger clock pulse? Negative edge trigger JK flip flop. Negative edge trigger JK flip flop. Binary ripple up counter using negative edge trigger JK flip flop. What is the circuit of a binary ripple up counter using positive edge trigger JK flip flop? Positive edge means Q bar to clock, right? Positive edge. You remember the very first circuit. Positive edge trigger JK flip flop up counter means connect Q bar to clock. Q bar to clock, Q bar to clock. Here, we have to use a negative edge trigger JK flip flop. So, first change the clock symbol in your circuit. Negative edge, right? So, now we are using a negative edge trigger JK flip flop. To make this circuit to work as up counter, positive edge trigger JK flip flop, we were connecting Q bar to clock. Here, you have to connect Q to clock. Q to clock and the clock is negative edge. This will work as what? Up counter using negative edge trigger JK flip flop. Up counter means you have to change the counting sequence. It counts from 0, 0, 0 till 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay? So this is binary ripple up counter using negative edge trigger JK flip flop. Next, binary ripple down counter using negative edge trigger JK flip flop. Binary ripple down counter using negative edge trigger JK flip flop means, just change this. Down counter means connect Q bar to clock. It is exactly opposite of your positive edge trigger flip flops. Okay? Connect Q bar to clock. Okay? So now this will work as what? Binary ripple down counter using negative edge trigger JK flip flop. So down counter, But at which edge it is going to trigger? It is going to trigger at the negative edge. So you have to indicate the negative edge of the clock. Negative edge. So this is the counting sequence. So this is how you can design a binary ripple up counter, down counter, using positive edge trigger JK flip-flop, using negative edge trigger JK flip-flop, or positive edge trigger T flip-flop, negative edge trigger T flip-flop. Okay? Let me just revise. Positive edge triggered flip-flops, okay, counter, positive edge triggered up counter, okay, let me write the table like this, okay, edge triggered flip-flops, okay, counter. So for positive, if you are using a positive edge triggered JK or T flip-flop, and if you want to design the up counter, you are going to connect Q bar to clock. You are going to connect Q bar of previous flip flop as clock pulse to the next flip flop. Same positive edge trigger JK or T flip flop. Down counter, you are going to connect Q to clock. You are going to connect Q to clock. Next. Negative edge trigger JK flip flop. If you are designing up counter, you are going to connect Q to clock. Okay, negative edge trigger JK or T flip flop. If you are going to connect this as down counter, you are going to connect it as connect Q bar to clock. You are going to connect Q bar to clock. Q bar to clock will work as down counter using negative edge trigger JK or T flip flop. So if the positive edge trigger, negative edge trigger, there does the complement modifications you have to do. So if you know this table, you can design both up and down counter using positive, negative edge trigger, JK or T flip flop. Now let us see the same circuit, how do I design both up and down counter? Okay, so I'll write the circuit.